1 week after the debut of the most visible part of Obamacare, the health insurance exchanges, Americans are still having trouble signing up. The main government website was shut down overnight for another upgrade, but the problems persist. We asked Anna Werner to have a look.
It's been a frustrating week for Matt Warren in Dallas. He's still fighting his way through the registration process on healthcare.gov to find out how much a plan will cost his family.
See, I don't accept the excuse of saying that the system is just overloaded. Perhaps it was overloaded, but I wish that it would have been built to withstand that load.
Many of the site's 8 million visitors could not log in, had long waits, or were stopped cold by error messages. The site was supposed to handle traffic from 30 million people in 36 states. David Simas is a White House senior advisor.
It's a volume issue that then required our team, both in terms of hardware and software, to address it, to deal with the volume that we were seeing, which was extraordinary. And a sign of good things to come.
One of the biggest drags on the system was ID verification. More computing power and software changes were added over the past 4 days to fix the system. Some state-run exchanges have fared better. New York State said today it signed up more than 40,000 residents on its website. After a week of trying, Brooklyn shoe designer Tori Knoll found the catastrophic coverage plan she was looking for, with a high deductible, nearly $13,000 a year, but a premium of $186 per month.
What was the feeling like for you when you finally got into?
It was a really good feeling. The website was working, and that was nice.
Now, we asked the Department of Health and Human Services to identify specific mistakes in the design process. They wouldn't. But Scott, we learned software that failed was designed by private contractors.
Anna, thanks very much.